Memphis Grizzlies are the only team led by Ja Morant to beat the top three teams in the Western Conference on their home court. So when I look at what Ja Morant is doing, his leadership, his swagger, Jay, you're a big social media guy. He's that guy that goes on social media and talk that big talk and back it up the next game. He's one of the most unguardable guys in the league today. He's a generational talent. And if I had to pick an MVP today, next Monday may change, but today, right now, it's Ja Morant, G12.
So all that MVP talk, that was before Ja did what he did last night in Cleveland. He scored 6 of his 26 points in the final 30 seconds, including the go-ahead basket. Memphis has now won 6 straight games. And get this, 4 of them, speaking of strength of opponents, are against the Suns, the Lakers, the Nets, and the Cavs. So here was Ja after the game on his mindset.
I don't fear nobody, dog. I don't care if you 7'7" or whatever. I'm coming straight at you.
All right, so I want to go back to what Perk said. Richard, do you agree with Perk that Ja could be the MVP?
Yeah, anything's possible. Like, anything is possible. We're not going to do it. Let's go by step. Let's go All-Star, All-NBA, and then MVP. Right now,
he's so All-Star this season.
I think without a doubt he's an All-Star this season. And I think he continues playing this way, then we're going to talk about him being an All-NBA performer. And, you know, possible most improved. And then the next step. MVP is not far off, but I do not have him in that conversation. Not yet. Now,
When
the facts change, so will my opinion. But right now, he is a bit outside that race.
Perk?
I just want to know why. Like, you can't just come here and tell me, just come on here and say the reigning Western Conference Player of the Week is just not in the MVP conversation when he has ran through majority of the NBA. Every time he steps on the floor with another MVP candidate, he always come out victorious or always come out on top. I'm just not understanding why is he not in the conversation. You can't just say he's not in my conversation without actually giving an explanation.
First of all, if we're going to say this, if we're going to talk about Jokic, we're going to talk about Kevin Durant, we're going to talk about Steph Curry. Like, these are the people that have a step above him. It takes a minute to get into that conversation. I am not disrespecting him. What is your issue right now?
I didn't say you was disrespecting them. But Malika, here it is, right? Because I'm done talking with RJ. So here's the thing. Throughout this season, so many players are playing so well that I feel like every month we're going to have this MVP conversation, okay?
Right.
You know, last month I was picking Kevin Durant. Okay, so then all of a sudden, Kevin Durant come out of protocol. He hasn't been playing well. Neither has Steph over the last 2 weeks. But I know who has been playing well and who team has elevated is Ja Morant.
Yeah.
So how can he not enter the conversation?
Really quickly, this is why. And this is no discredit to Ja. Part of the reason why his team excelled when he was out, and I will never disrespect Ja and hold that against him, but it was like, it's not like he missed time, his team struggled,
but
he came back.
But isn't there something to be said of picking up, just because we've seen, you know, going into COVID protocols, and he was injured on top of the COVID protocols, and that's a compounded thing, but seeing players come back from these COVID protocols, it shouldn't be taken for granted, right, that they're going to come back as the exact same player they was before. We heard LaMarcus Aldridge talk today just about how taxing it was on his body to go through that. So shouldn't that be almost factored in, the fact that he is coming back the same player, even though his team was able to stay afloat without him?
Well, look, at the end of the day, Perk and I don't have votes. I understand why he doesn't. I probably deserve one. But this is the biggest issue with this, is that you can't go 1 week it's this guy, 1 week it's that guy. We understand that as this season progresses, you have to maintain this level of excellence. And he has yet to do that. And I'm not saying that he won't. I'm just saying merely that it's too early to be like, he's in this conversation. He just got back. He missed 2 weeks.
No, but bro, that is so not accurate, for the simple fact that when the season first started, I remember us doing a segment on NBA Today on this show about Ja Morant and what he was doing and for why he was averaging X amount of points for his he had upped his points by almost 10 points a game at the start of the season, leading the league in points in the paint. And then he got hurt and went into the protocol. DeMar DeRozan went into the protocol. The Bulls kept excelling. Do you have him in the MVP conversation, Richard?
No.
No. You don't have DeMar DeRozan in the MVP conversation. Well, that's a whole different conversation.
DeMar, it's early. It's early.
Here's the thing. I had this conversation with Doris Burke a couple of weeks ago about the MVP narrative. When we start having these discussions so long before the MVP is actually voted on, is there room for people to change their minds? Because at the beginning of the season, it was Steph Curry, and it was very clear the reason why. Kevin Durant nipping at his heels. Giannis Antetokounmpo in that conversation. So if you look at the total body of work, if Ja Morant keeps this up,
that's the key. Keep it up.
Thanks for watching ESPN on YouTube. For live streaming sports and premium content, subscribe to ESPN+.